اللي هي فعلا على العمل المجهود اللي عم بتقول فيه، لأنه فعلا رفع من اسم وصورة الخيل العربي بالعالم كله.
أشكركم جزيل الشكر. مشاهدينا الكرام، حديثنا يتواصل بعد فاصل قصير، ابقوا معنا.
أوكي.
Top table, if you could take your seats. Top table, take your seats, please. Do keep your phones on, but please put them on silent. Ladies and gentlemen, do come in. Do come down to the front. Yes, that's your seat. Just for you. Do come in, ladies and gentlemen, do be seated. Lady jockeys, make certain you get out because you're coming onto the stage. This is what it's about. Bring in a drink or whatever. Do come in.
أهلا بكم من جديد مشاهدينا الكرام. كما تلاحظون الصورة من خلفي، بدأت القاعة تمتلئ بالأشخاص المعنيين في هذا المؤتمر الصحفي. سريعا أرحب بضيفي الكريمين، سامي البعنين رئيس الاتحاد الدولي لسباقات الخيول العربية الأصيلة، أهلا وسهلا فيك.
يا مرحبا فيك.
يا هلا مرحبا. أيضا رحب بالدكتور عبد الله الرئيس مدير عام الأرشيف الوطني، أهلا وسهلا يا دكتور.
يا هلا مرحبا.
يا هلا مرحبا. قبل ما نبدأ المؤتمر خلني أسألك عن الهدف من مثل هالمؤتمرات، وأنت كرئيس للاتحاد الدولي شنو مطمعك أن هذا المؤتمر يخرج منه؟
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طبعا في البداية أحب أشكركم في قناة ياس، لا أنسى كذلك الشكر الجزيل لسمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد النهيان لدعم الخيل العربية الأصيلة وسباقاتها في مختلف دول العالم، وعلى هذا المهرجان الكبير والضخم الذي بدأ من العاصمة هنا أبوظبي وانتقل حول العالم والآن رجعنا مرة أخرى إلى أبوظبي. طبعا الأمنيات والطموح كبيرة، خاصة يعني مثل ما تقول بالنسبة للخيل العربية الأصيلة، يعني الخيل العربية الأصيلة تحتاج إلى دعم شامل، والحمد لله طبعا هناك يوجد دعم على المستوى الدولي المستوى العالمي، شاهدنا سباقات كبرى عالمية. الآن طبعا أغنى سباقات العالم راح يقام يوم 8 الشهر، وهو طبعا سباق كبير للخيل العربية الأصيلة وأكبر جائزة تقدم في هنا في العاصمة أبوظبي، وهذا دعم كبير. طبعا من هذه من ضمن الأمنيات اللي كنا نطمح فيها، الحمد لله وصلنا إلى أن نكون في سباقات كبيرة، خيل تتقدم من مختلف فأعتقد أن هذا سباق كبير.
وجود بن زايد النهيان نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء وزير شؤون الرئاسة على رعايته ودعمه اللامحدود لسباقات المحطة الأخيرة من سباقات الخيول العربية في من أجل تسويق أنشطته وبرامجه، خصوصا أن هناك أكثر من 100 سباق حول العالم فرصة للتسويق لأنشطة وبرامج، طبعا لما في مصلحة التاريخ وتراث دولة.
Kelsey, have you arrived? Kelsey Purcell, have you arrived? Nice green. We have, please come along here. We want to fill everything. There's plenty of room over here. Well done. All right. Keep moving. Thank you, Pat. Yeah, I know you're here. Keep moving down the front, guys. Please fill up the seats. We want it to look as if it's full. We're going live around the world. This is the man. Tell us exactly what you do.
Well, actually, I run Jannah Hotels and Resort. So actually, it's a lot of fun for me because I do something that I love. And I actually get very excited just before when this festival starts, my team and I, every year, just before the festival, you know, we know where you're coming. We know you're coming from the whole world. And we get excited, and we thank you very much for choosing Jannah Hotels and Resort. Yes. We actually just opened the hotel, and because of the festival, it's full.
That is incredible.
It is. So thank you very much.
And is it the newest what in Abu Dhabi?
Yes, this is the newest five-star hotel in Abu Dhabi, and it's called Jannah Burj Al Arab. It's on the Corniche Road. Very beautiful, great view. Yes. Whoever could not stay here, could not stay there this year, you should stay there next year.
Well, that is jolly good. And you know, anybody wants to put you up for free of charge?
Sure. Anytime.
Big fella, enjoy. If you want anything, he is the man. And he. Ladies and gentlemen, we are live tonight, and we are going live around the world. My name is Derek Thompson. Very soon, I'm going to introduce you to the top table. But first of all, can I say thank you very much for coming. Are you all enjoying yourselves here in Abu Dhabi? Yes. Whoa! Whoa! And it's amazing you've come from all over the world, and the reason you've come here is because of this. This is what it's about. This is the Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan jewel crown. And this really is the jewel in the crown. It is 1.2 million euros. That's the prize money. This is solid gold. There are diamonds all around the horse's head. That is the jewel. Who would like to take that home with them on Sunday night? Put your hand up if you want to take that home. Do you want to take it home? Is it going to go to America?
Yes.
I hope so.
Is it going to go to France?
Yes.
Is it going to go to the United Arab Emirates?
Yes.
Well, and anybody from Holland want to take this home with them? Anybody from France want to win this? All right then. I love it. I love it. But the world is here. We had over 70 horses nominated for this race that Lara announced back in January. And when she announced it, she said, I've got a surprise for you. And I've never had a surprise quite like this. But because of her, because of Sheikh Mansour, that's the reason we're all here. And it's going to be very special. We're going to introduce you to all the people on the top table. Then we're going to get the jockeys up, the apprentices, the ladies, and also a lady jockey who's come from America to ride. And as we all know, the big race in Australia, the Melbourne Cup, was won by a lady jockey who actually rode in the Sheikh of Fatima race 2 years ago. I think we should give Michelle Payne a big round of applause. Well done, Australia. Well done, Michelle. Ladies and gentlemen, the lady who does so much, please welcome Miss Lara Sawaya.
First of all, thank you for coming to the capital of the world, Abu Dhabi. Abu Dhabi today is hosting the world's richest pure Arabian bred. And the mentor of the world, the late our father. 1.2 million euro is a prize money which will crown the best prize money ever. It's something very special that has been created by a very beautiful and young woman, Emirati, Azza Al-Kubaisi. We've been working with Azza since years, since we started the festival of Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed, since 7 years. Today, Azza wanted to crown the world's richest pure Arabian bred and the world's richest Arabian horse race. It's a gold trophy with diamonds in the name of Sheikh Zayed. When you see it on the first prize, whoever the winner is, it's diamonds, amethyst, emerald. It's one crown, the crown of Baba Zayed for the winner. This wow. is a very traditional crown, which we wanted to show the world that we had a triple jewel in the United States. We had three jewels in the US. It was the amethyst, which we started in Texas. It was afterwards the emerald, which was in California in Pleasanton. And the last one was the diamond in, of course, California, Los Alamitos. For the triple crown, we started it in Toulouse. And then we came to Holland, to Dordrecht. And of course, the last race was in Poland. The jewel is the three jewels. The crown is the gold. It's the triple crown that makes the world richest Arabian horse race in the world. We featured it inside a beautiful trophy, which the winner deserves it. And as well as the jockey, he will get the same, and the trainer will get the same. So thank you, Azza Al-Kubaisi, the best Emirati woman that tried to do something beautiful to crown the world's richest race.
Superb.
Yes, I think we need to clap for Azza
Al-Kubaisi. Outstanding.
As you can see, we have a very special trophy too, two very special trophies. We need to salute our soldiers. Thanks to His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Salman and his directives, we have two races in the names of UAE Martyrs Trophy and UAE Martyrs Cup. Two special trophies were done also, as you can see on our right. It's specially done also by Azza Al-Kubaisi, by Arts and Gems. And this is the clothes of the soldiers, as you can see in the trophy, with the horse. And this is just to salute all our soldiers. May their souls rest in peace, with the most beautiful two races, one Arabian horse race and another thoroughbred race. We do not want to forget the Ladies' World Championship of the Mother of the World, Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak, who has given many countries the opportunities to participate inside, as well as the Ladies' World Championship, Apprentice World Championship, which I need to tell Remy, we are 40 countries, Remy, not 26. Where is Remy? 40 countries, Remy, and clap for Ifra. Countries is a big number, and we ended it today by saying Uruguay, Uruguay, Switzerland, and Russia. May you stand up, please, Uruguay, Russia, and Switzerland.
Come on, stand up. Well done, guys. Thank you.
Zintel, you can stand up, and we can have Uruguay.
See you in St. Moritz.
Yes. Thanks for your support and thanks for your trust in the International Federation of Horse Racing Academies for the best team ever, because we will be taking care of all of you apprentices. The Mother of the World has given you the chance to see the best conference ever for Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak Training and Education Conference. First time ever in the National Archive, which we need to thank Dr. Abdullah for making us UN's Hall for the first time ever, and it will be live definitely on YAS TV, which we are very proud to be also streaming on www.sheikhmansourfestival.com. So thank you all for being here. 600 guests from the world arrived to the capital of the world, Abu Dhabi. Welcome to all. Thank you.
Thank you. Lara Suwaya. Could I now please welcome Mr. Essam Abdullah. Essam.
Sorry. Thank you, Doctor. I would like to welcome all and each of you for coming to our countries I hope you enjoyed the race. I cannot wish everybody win. Only one will win, but I think at the end, everybody wins. We have grown and made an exceptional race, added to the horses, racing horses in the UAE and International Arabian Horse. The country, in terms of Arabian horse, have been adapting rules and regulations since 1993 of two breeds of racing, including Arabs. We have started and basically tried all these years to concentrate in promoting the Arab horse in the region, and we succeeded to even now do it as a promotional for Arab horse in the whole world. That's because of the support of a lot of peoples, but on top of that is His Highness Sheikh Mansour, who really deserve the big admire for what he done for the Arab horse. Thank you.
Well said. Well said. Thank you. Now please welcome, where is he? Sami Alvuainen.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Sami Alvuainen, chairman of IFAR, the International Federation of Arab Horse Racing Authorities. First of all, I would like to thank United Arab Emirates, especially Abu Dhabi, the capital of United Arab Emirates. Also, His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan for all his support for the Arabian horses all over the world, the racing, the conference. Also, Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bin Mubarak for all her support for the ladies race all over the world. And also, I don't want to forget the magic, Lara Sawaya. She did really fantastic job. For so many years now she's been working. We think that's going to take really long time, but actually it takes just a couple of years. It's not even count of one hand's fingers. We are reaching the world. We are reaching the top race in the world. The richest race in the world is going to be here in United Arab Emirates. Also, you could see there is in the declaration, there is horses from United States, there is from United Arab Emirates, from Qatar, from Europe. And I believe this race will show performance and will show the quality of the horses. Also, I would like to thank you guys. You travel long distance to be here, and this is make really good festival, good conferences, and also good racing we're going to witness. The support of His Highness Sheikh Mansour and United Arab Emirates, it reflects really into IFAR. We get more countries now as country members, and also the support make the racing in all over the world. In the racetrack, Arabian horses, they are important horses, and the racing, it looks really glitter, and more owners, they get involved. And now, as Lara mentions in the IFAR General Assembly, we would like to see more European owners and Americans, of course, to be involved in racing and come to the big race next year here in the United Arab Emirates. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Sami. Well said. Of course, the build-up is rather special, and over the next few days, the build-up, we're going to have workshops, we're going to have everything. Dr. Abdullah Reyes, tell us more.
Thank you. Ladies, and gentlemen. First of all, that's not racist. First of all, thank you so much for accepting our invitation to come to the capital of the world of Arabian horse racing, Abu Dhabi, and taking some of your precious time to be here with us and in this beautiful weather. You cannot find better than this. I am honored to be here with this unique group of people. And I would like to thank my boss, His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Deputy Prime Minister, Minister of Presidential Affairs, for his unlimited and unparalleled support of Arabian horse racing. And also to the mother of the world, Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak, for her unlimited support of not only horse racing, but also support of women in all areas. And in particular, the ladies in UAE, we have 5 ministers in the cabinet, and we have lady ministers, and we have many in the parliament. And we have everywhere ladies in UAE serving side by side by other male in UAE. So this is astonishing achievement for ladies in UAE, and thank to Her Highness for this. I would also like to thank Lara Sawaya for her continuous support of Arabian horse racing. It's not the time for telephone.
I was just going to say, who's left his telephone? I love it.
For her exhaustive travel everywhere, every time I call her, she's in the sky. I don't know when she is on land. But she's always traveling, chasing tournaments, chasing jockeys, chasing trainers, chasing everyone. That is unique. Unique as a career and unique as a profession, and you cannot find in anybody in this profession. Someone who is dedicated to her job. And one trick of Lara is that she can come, she becomes your friend from the first glance at her. I remember when she met my wife, she just first time say hello and she fell in love with her, with Lara. I would like also to welcome you to the National Archives tomorrow for over 3 days. And so you will see what is the National Archives, which has been built under the directives of Highness Sheikh Mansour, from scratch, and it became now number one in the world in terms of technology, in terms of organization, and we are transferring our knowledge and services to other parts of the world also. And last month, we won the Stevie Awards among 3,600 entries, participating more than 60 countries, and we won 6 prizes. 6 trophies.
Congratulations.
So, thank you to him. So our next goal is to have Lara win all these trophies soon.
Why not?
Yeah. So I'm really, really, really thrilled to see all of you at the National Archives tomorrow morning. And believe me, the surprises you will see tomorrow, you have never seen anywhere else. And tomorrow the opening ceremony will be something very special and unique from a special woman, Lara. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Doc. It is going to be incredible tomorrow. Now please welcome Sultan Ayuda. Sultan, over to you. That's what I said.
Good evening, everyone. Or now it's good night, almost. Good night, everyone, and welcome to Abu Dhabi, the capital of the world, capital of Arabian race horses, the capital of the UAE. And I hope you, everyone, will enjoy the stay in Abu Dhabi, and then very nice weather is the best period in the year to be in Abu Dhabi and to enjoy the race on Sunday. Welcome again for everybody here in Abu Dhabi, and I hope you all will enjoy the race on Sunday. Thank you.
Thank you, as always, Sultan. Our sponsors are so, so good. Khalid Al-Hamadi, we travel the world. He's a top man. Khalid.
Good evening. My name is Khalid Al-Hamadi, Director of Sports Department and General Authority for Youth and Sports. Welcome, everybody, here in Abu Dhabi, United Arab Emirates, capital of the Arabian horse racing. I'll start my speech in Arabic, sorry. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أصحاب السعادة السيدات والسادة الحضور من قيادات رياضية ومهتمين برياضة الفروسية والإعلامية من كافة أرجاء العالم تحية طيبة. وبعد مع استمرار نجاحات مهرجان سمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد العالمي للخيول العربية الأصيلة، أتشرف أن أنقل لكم تحيات معالي الشيخ نهيان بن مبارك آل نهيان وزير الثقافة والشباب وتنمية المجتمع رئيس الهيئة العامة لرعاية الشباب والرياضة، وإشادة معاليه لما وصل إليه مهرجان سمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد آل نهيان نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء وزير شؤون الرئاسة العالمي للخيول العربية الأصيلة خلال سنوات قليلة بإنجازات كبيرة وبدعم لا محدود من سمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد آل نهيان للخيول العربية والملاك والمدربين وخلق الحوافز من خلال جوائز عالمية وعقد المؤتمرات العلمية. أكبر الأثر في استمراريته وتطوره السريع. ولا ننسى الإدارة المحترفة للمهرجان بقيادة سعادة لارا صوايا المدير التنفيذي لمهرجان سمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد العالمي للخيول العربية الأصيلة. وفي هذه الأيام عشاق الخيل وهواة السباقات على موعد لحضور السباق الأقوى والأغلى على مستوى العالم، سباق جوهرة تاج الشيخ زايد بن سلطان آل نهيان الخيول العربية الأصيلة ونهائي بطولة العالم لسمو الشيخة فاطمة بنت مبارك للسيدات، إلى جانب المؤتمر العالمي لأم الإمارات سمو الشيخة فاطمة بنت مبارك لمدارس تطوير مهارات الفرسان في عاصمة الخيل العربي أبوظبي. وفي الختام أتوجه بالشكر والتقدير لسمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد آل نهيان على دعمه ورعايته ومتابعته الدائمة، ولسمو الشيخة فاطمة بنت مبارك أم الإمارات أم العالم اهتمامها الخاص بالرياضة بشكل نسائية بشكل خاص على مستوى دولة الإمارات وعلى مستوى العالم. متمنين للجميع التوفيق ونجاح والاستمتاع في أجواء البطولة وشكرا.
Where would we be without the people who support us? Please welcome Sheikh Hamdan Al-Shaki.
Good evening, everybody. On behalf of Abu Dhabi Investment Company, I would like to welcome everybody to Abu Dhabi, the capital of the world, of the Arabian horses. And on behalf of Invest AD, I would be like really grateful to see all of you on Sunday on the final race. I wish all of the best to the winner. There is one winner, and there is no loser in that race. So everybody is a winning. Wish you all of the best, and thank you.
Thank you. And now, one of my favorite ladies, Al-Shehi. All yours.
Good evening, everybody. I am Sheikh Al-Shehi from General Women Union. أساد الحضور الكرام. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يطيب لي أن أتقدم بجزيل الشكر والتقدير لجهود ودعم سمو الشيخة فاطمة بنت مبارك رئيسة الاتحاد النسائي العام، الرئيس الأعلى لمؤسسة التنمية الأسرية، رئيسة المجلس الأعلى للأمومة والطفولة، لمونديال أم الإمارات للسيدات والفرسان المتدربين أفار، والذي ساهم في إحداث نقلة نوعية لسباقات الفروسية في تلك الفئتين، وحرص أم الإمارات على دعم الرياضة النسائية عامة ورياضة الفروسية خاصة لارتباط تلك الرياضة بتراث الدولة، وحرص سموها على توفير فرص الاحتكاك للفارسات والفرسان المتدربين من جميع دول العالم بهدف إكسابهم خبرات جديدة لمنافسة النجوم العالميين في السباقات الكبيرة والعالمية. وأتوجه ببالغ شكر وتقدير المرأة الإماراتية لسمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد آل نهيان نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء وزير شؤون الرئاسة على دعمه اللامحدود للمهرجان في مختلف أنشطته بمجال الفروسية، مما ساهم في ارتقاء بسباقات الخيول العربية الأصيلة وزيادة شعبيتها في مختلف مناظير العالم. ومن دواعي الفخر لنا أن نقوم بالمشاركة في مهرجان سمو الشيخ منصور بن زايد آل نهيان العالمي للخيول العربية، وتأتي مشاركتنا بتوجيه من سمو الشيخة فاطمة بنت مبارك التي يمارس الخيل وسباقات القدرة والتحمل. كما أتمنى أن يحظى ختام مهرجان النسخة السابعة بالإقبال الجماهير المتوقع، وأن يحافظ والتوفيق الفرسان المشاركين في السباقات مما يساهم في تحقيق النجاح المنشود منها. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
I'm going to stick with this guy. Can I just say, the first question I always ask this gentleman, he's married to one of the most beautiful and successful ladies in the Middle East. So, Dr. Nadasa, where is your wife tonight? Where is she over the next
among you as a plastic surgeon. I really support this this festival because it represents the strength of the Arabic woman. I'm so proud to be here and honored. I would like to thank Mrs. Lara Sawaya for her effort and wish her prosperity in every single work she's doing. Really, we are so proud as Arabic to have the capital of the world for horse racing. And a big thanks for His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed. Thank you.
Thank you. It's funny you should say, to the old fanrats, is that the best airline in the world?
Well, in fact, I'm really speechless in front of this amazing crowd today here. This is another proof that Abu Dhabi is not only the capital of Arabian horses. Abu Dhabi is the home of the world, by all means. And when I say home, I'm sure all of you will agree with me that in home you feel safe, secured, and relaxed. And this is a seed that His Highness Sheikh Zayed, the founder of the UAE, have planted. And what we see today of a festival of His Highness Sheikh Mansour is a responsibility to keep on this seed growing more and more, to host more people like you here. I will not talk about Emirates Airline. I hope you, all of you, enjoyed your flight coming in. If not, please, you can refer to Derek and he will help you. I hope you will enjoy your stay and enjoy the big race that's going on. Last word is a big thank to my dearest colleague, Lara. Lara, well done on everything. Thank you for bothering me with your Instagram, the rest of social media. And good luck to all of you. Thank you.
Thanks for coming. We're saying best to the end. Come on, Ahmed Said, what would you like to say?
First of all, good evening, everyone. I'm running late. We have a derby, classic derby for football game. And all the TV people, they know about that. First of all, I want to introduce myself. My name is Ahmed Said. I'm representing the Abu Dhabi Judicial Department. And I'm in charge of the sport court, which is CAS, the one from Lausanne. And my background, it's all about football. And I used to ride the horse also when I was young. I have some brothers who's also in as a trainer, for horse trainer. So I come from a sports family, half of them in football field and half of them in sport and horse racing. I'm so happy to see you here. It's really a blast to see all these people from different countries around the world visiting Abu Dhabi. Big things for Abu Dhabi city, and I hope you are enjoying the staying here. Thank you very much.
We are. And this gentleman has been pretty busy today. Kai Schermann from Germany. Tell us more.
Hello, good evening for everybody. I'm Kai Schermann from the German Jockey School and the jockey coach for all the apprentices that are riding around the world for the Dakar race. I want to say thank you to Lara that she trusts in my work, and I'm very happy here for all the apprentices. For next year also, for all the amateur lady riders.
Good.
And for all the riders that are here, I wish you the best and good luck for the race on Sunday.
Thank you, Ken.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome you all to this little humble event that we're having in the desert. It's very, very nice to see everybody. And as Laura has been saying, advertising it, in fact, as the marriage or the wedding in the desert. It's lovely to see all so many friends over the past, what, 5 or 6 years, Laura, that have become part of the racing, the Arabian racing fraternity. We know so many people now, and it's all thanks to the great enthusiasm of His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed and, of course, Her Highness Sheikha Fatima bint Mubarak. But nothing could have happened without the great organization ability of the one and only... I'd like to welcome our two guests here in the front. They're very brave people, and they've come here, and we hope that they enjoyed the festival in the Abu Dhabi environment for the next few days and nights, might I say. There are various events going on in the evenings as well. But the racing, the Arabian racing here in the United Arab Emirates has really taken off in the last few years. I've been here for 25 years, and it was a bit of a struggle in the early years to get it going. But now, since His Highness Sheikha Fatima stepped in to encourage the various facets of racing, Her Highness Sheikha Fatima has encouraged so much the lady situation, the woman, the woman's guild, union, or whatever. And I think it is fair to say that probably the fruition of the efforts was shown in Australia yesterday morning when the lady jockey won that race they call a cup, the Melbourne Cup, yeah. Emirates Melbourne Cup, sorry. Son, Sheikh Hamdan bin Mansour, he's having his, I believe, his first runner, which is very innovative, and it's a great honour, I would think, to have his first runner in the best Arabian race in the world, worth 1.2 million. Now, the 1.2 million is relative in most respects, but the fact is that we have a championship race. Whether they're running for half a million or a quarter million or 100,000, the quality of the horses taking part are some of, well, not some of, they are the best horses in the world, let's face it, you know. And it is fair to give the connections the... what should we say? If the horses don't run up to their top form, it's probably the vast number of hours they spent in the aeroplane, the different climate, and, well, many other things that people who are connected with horses will understand what I'm trying to say. Anyway, enough about the horses and the racing. We look forward to Sunday very, very forward. If we don't have individual owners, we don't have individual trainers, we don't have individual, now I must say sponsors. And I would like to say a very big thank you to our sponsor here, National Flower and Feed, who are sponsoring the big race on Sunday night. And it is a great honour to have the sponsorship from this particular gentleman and his company, and long may it continue. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, that's enough from me. Let's get on and get the race won, eh? Yeah.
Pat Buckley, thank you. Well done, big fella. Ladies and gentlemen, could I just bring them on? You did mention two brothers who come from America, and this is very interesting. I know you love watching sport in America, Doc. Let's bring these, can I bring the Powell brothers up? Scott and Mark Powell, come and join us, because they've got two horses. Come and join us. They've got two horses called So Big Is Better. You'll be hoping that wins. And what's your horse called? Day. Paddy's Day. Why is he called Paddy's Day?
He's born on what was it? Whatever Paddy's
St. Patrick's Day.
Patrick's Day.
Patron Saint of Ireland.
Yep.
Now, where have you come from? And tell us about your horse.
We got him from Jane and Ray Toys, and Jim and Nikki, who are partners on him and us, decided that that would be a good prospect, and we worked out a deal with Jane and Ray Toys and purchased him, and here we are.
How many races has he won? How many races has he run in?
I think he's got 10 wins out of 13 starts.
It would have been 11, but last time out he got beaten by a horse owned by your brother.
I like to forget that. I'm still struggling with that in my mind, but you know what? It's been perfect how it worked out.
So the rematch is on, and how is So Big Is Better?
It was a long travel. It took a few days with to get situated, but he's a veteran, so he's feeling good.
He's won 29 out of 60. It's a near 50% strike rate. And he made history earlier this year by doing what in Group 1 races?
He was the oldest horse of any breed to win a Grade 1 race.
And he's 11 years old.
He's 11 years old. So very old.
Guys, good luck to you both on Sunday.
Hey, for the record, I'm really happy to have my brother here with me and all our family. And we have a great rivalry. But you know what? It's in the family, so bottom line is, we'll take it.
Go for it, big fella. Well done, both of you. And you know with Doc, yes?
Yes, before we are dismissed by Lara, I would like also not to forget one integral part of all this show and all the races around the world, the fantastic coverage of Yas TV.
Yeah, yeah.
Please give them well a big hand. Thank you. And you mentioned about the American sport. I'm a Green Bay Packers fan.
We know.
So anybody opposing to that, raise your hand so you will not be fit tonight. Thank you.
Doc, you are a star. But there is somebody else here, because we were talking about a lady in Australia who won the one of the richest races in the world, the Melbourne Cup. And I wonder, will a lady jockey ride the winner of this race, the world's richest racer, Purebred Arabians, all the way from America? We really have two women. 1 week winning two of the richest races in the world?
Wouldn't that be amazing? It would be great, too. Yeah. It'd be great.
First of all, tell us about your thoughts on Michelle Payne winning the Emirates Melbourne Cup.
I think just like in America, we had Anne Rosie Novinick. And it shows you every country can have that kind of woman.
What chance have you got? You ride that lovely horse, Paddy's Day. How many times have you ridden him? How many times have you won on it?
He's ran 13 times, so I've rode him 12. I've only been off. And I've won everything on him except once. So yeah.
So what about racing on Sunday? You're running on right-handed. You're running on a grass track. What are your thoughts?
I'm excited. I've raced on the grass before. Going to the right, that's going to be something new for me and him. but I think we can handle it.
Well, I think you can as well. And I tell you what I'd like you to do now. I know you're not in the ladies' race. You're in the big race, the richest ever race for purebred Arabians. Could you now go and stand behind? I'm going to get the lady jockeys up as well and the apprentice jockeys. And if you can stand in the middle. Would that be all right, cousin?
Yes, thank you so much. And thank you for having all of us, Sheikh Mansour and Laura Sawarski.
Thank you. Star. Okay, could we now welcome the lady jockeys who qualified for the Sheikh of Fatima Ladies World Championship. Would you please come on stage and join us? Please welcome from Australia, Tracy O'Hara. From Denmark, Sabina Gammelgaard. Come on, give them a big round of applause as they come up. Justine Mercier from France. Rebecca Smith, Great Britain. Paige Fuller, Great Britain. Anne Stokel, Great Britain. Alexander Bahari from Hungary. Come and join us live on stage. From Ireland, Lisa O'Neill. From Mauritius, Niven Made. From Oman, Said Al-Yahahi. From Puerto Rico, Gilmar Torres Roman. From Russia, this is Emil Kunabeya. From Turkey, Ismail Koyunku. And also the other apprentices, Australia, Ben Thompson. Zoe Vandervel from Belgium, Ruby Viana from Brazil, Brandon Duchesne from Canada, Isaias Magnin from France, Connor Hoban from Ireland, Andrea Felle from Italy, from Japan, please welcome, Aoi Kinome, from Oman, Azar Alwadi, from Korea, Anna Lee, from Josephine Landgren. Give them a big round of applause. From Sweden, Anna Pilroth. From Switzerland, Astrid Wildschläger, and the United States of America, Sandy D. Martin. These are the girls who have qualified to be here, and this is going to be incredible.
Tomo.
What do you think of all this?
You've mixed the apprentice with the ladies, so they need to know where's the ladies. Here, and we have apprentices on the right of
the
Emirates.
Well spotted. So should we put all the apprentices this side and all the ladies?
We are one combination. But we want to say one thing, that the Brazil still did not arrive. They are arriving. The visa of the Brazilian jockey is already set to go, and the Brazilian and the apprentice jockey, Omar and Bushra, they are tonight. So those three jockeys are missing. We need to clap these jockeys.
He is standing up, honestly.
And still there are jockeys arriving on your left. Can we have the jockeys that have just arrived also all stand up, all the jockeys?
They are, everybody stand up. It's amazing this. They've had these series around the world.
A surprise for you.
Surprise.
Yes.
What is it?
The surprise of you is
what?
A surprise also for National Feed and Flower, production and marketing. The jewel crown of Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan, associate partner, €1.2 million. I know you are ladies that raced in the world's
championship of Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bin Mubarak, and also for you, the apprentices have taken part in the world's richest apprentice racing in the name of the mother of the world, Sheikha Fatma bin Mubarak. You are all invited to the jockeys that arrive in Abu Dhabi. They will be in under the directives of His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and you are invited to Abu Dhabi in to celebrate. You are coming to celebrate Valentine's Day.
Oh, hey, 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 February 14th.
And this is all. Thank, please, guys, 1 minute. I know you're all excited, but we thank very much our sponsors, our associate. Festival, one. Abu Dhabi, the capital. You are the jockeys of the world, and we are all proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Well done, guys. You're coming February the 14th. The best Valentine's present you've ever had. By the way, tell us more about what's happening in February. Go on.
No. We cannot tell you all because we have many surprises coming on next week in November. Before we start and we finish, there is something going on very important. We need the endurance jockeys that arrive to UAE too. Can you stand up, please? All the French team, from the French team, from the Italy team, and definitely we have UAE, but they are not here. Can we have the endurance jockeys stand up?
Come on, guys.
All the endurance jockeys.
Come on, everybody up.
Can we have you also on stage on the right side, please, of the Emirates girl?
Come and join us.
Can you come on stage, please? You have the champions of Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak CEIO Cup that took place in Italy. And it's the only CEIO Cup, FEI, and these champions arrive to Abu Dhabi. Can we have you not from here? No, from the left. Venez ici.
Come around this
vous side. Allez à gauche, s'il vous
they're
plaît.
They're used to going a long way. They're okay.
Allez-y. All these champions have also the jockeys. We are very fascinated.
On Sunday. Enjoy yourself. And
before we go, Tomo.
Yes, before we go.
guys, tomorrow you need to leave early, as Dr. Abdallah said. What will happen in the National Archive for the first 10 minutes never happened entirely in the world.
What is it? What is it? What is it? Oh, we've got to get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow you will know, Tomo.
I love it. 10 o'clock tomorrow.
Yes, but we can also need to thank all the media that came from all over the world, all the UAE media. Give them a big clap. They
Top
came
fans.
From 300. And the main thank you goes to TCA Abu Dhabi. We are sustained by TCA Abu Dhabi. Thank you, His Excellency Muhammad Al Mubarak and His Excellency Jasim Al Darmaki, to give us their great support. And we do not need to forget one and only Sheikh Nahyan bin Zayed. Thank you for your support from Abu Dhabi Sports Council. And of course, His Excellency Arif Al Awani. I know Arif is not here, but Arif is in China, but he will arrive hopefully tomorrow and be with all of you. Before we leave, the beautiful girls will give gifts for all these jockeys.
All right.
And definitely they will all get their gifts whenever they get out of here. The girls will have a distinguished, the ladies' horse race.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
They're going to get something. What about us down here?
Yes.
Would you like to get a free gift?
With lots of gifts. And this is all thanks to our sponsors. We need to tell you that you will enjoy a week full of events. The first night will be tomorrow with a very beautiful designer.
She's
put in a show. The second night, on a very great, so you mosque, what you will sit and your background, the United Arab Emirates, Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan, may his soul rest in peace, with only one race in the world, is, what is the name? The jewel what?
Dukan.
Why you are sleeping? I want to hear the name of the world's richest Arabian horse race. No one knows the name of the race, huh? You don't. What is the name of the race, guys? I want to hear. I did not hear. Okay, the guys shouted. What is the name of the race? Okay, before we end up, there's only one world's richest Arabian horse race. It's the Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan Jewel Crown. But we want to say thank you, Dawood Aka. Thank you for the best jockeys. C'est Valérie, no? Valérie Sall. Okay, clap to them because they deserve your clap. They are two jockeys who came from France. They have been riding and they are here with us. The wheelchair is nothing. This is your strong willingness for going to the front. You are part of the festival. The festival will embrace you wherever you go, all times. You are the invitees of Sheikh Mansour Festival. And in the race, you will have a special award granted from His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan Global Arabian Horse Flat Racing Festival only for you. But I would like ask you, Sultan Al-Zahiri, he has a meeting, so he came late.
So we want you, Tomo, now to talk to Sultan, because Sultan is the executive director of TCA Abu Dhabi for all events and activities.
What time? Where have you been?
I think I'm using the Arabic timing. Maybe.
Listen, you made it. What would you like to say to everybody here? We've had a marvelous, marvelous time and so much looking forward to Sunday.
Well, I would like to welcome all of you here. And I think this is a great success to have this.
Festival, who we've done it fast. Put the world in a 300 meters on the 22nd or 15th of November.
Who's going to take the photo?
The Zayed Heritage.
Mohaf.
Sheikh Zayed Heritage.
Have you got a wide one?
20th of November, but definitely watch. You will be the first to see the whole construction that is taking place, and an official picture will go to the world, only this picture in front of Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan Garden in Al Wasba. It's a very beautiful landmark, which is done to contribute to his to the late Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan. Thanks to everybody. We need you over there on Friday. This special picture will go in all the newspapers in the world, in Paris, Racing Post, everywhere that is that are contributed and partnered with us, all the media in UAE. This is all of you saying thank you from us to him in heaven. Thank you, Baba Zayed, for everything you've allowed us to have here in Abu Dhabi.
Doc, just say a few words. You were going to say something.
Yeah, regarding tomorrow, if you arrive early or earlier than 10, say 7:36.
Yes.
Well, as you enter the National Archives, in front you will see a fountain which has seven leaves representing seven emirates. And on the largest one is written, those who knows his history has neither present nor future. This is the saying of Sheikh Zayed.
Okay.
And on your right hand, there is an exhibition about the history of UAE films. 3D theater, which is showing the documentary about the history of UAE from the ancient ages until today. It's in a 20 minutes documentary movie, which will be open throughout the day, so you can go in any time you want. It's 20. these two things that you should see, because you will know better about the history and heritage of UAE in documents and films. And when you go to the theater, this is 700 seats theater on two different levels, the balcony 200, the first floor 500. And it's all beautifully designed, and any movement is captured automatically.
Is it free to get in?
Of course.
Hey, we'll be there. We are dark, you're a star. Ladies and gentlemen.
I look forward to seeing all of you there in the morning. I will be there 6 o'clock if you have...
We'll be there 6:05. Ladies and gentlemen, can we give the top table and all the competitors a big round of applause from the Eastern Mangroves Hotel. A very good night to you. Thank you,
saying
guys,
that he comes at 6 a.m. I want to see if he comes at 6 a.m.
I'll be there at 6 o'clock. Photographer, highest paid photographer in the world. Yes. Oh, I better get in this. Hang on. Yes, everybody in. Come on, let's go. Here we go. I hope he's got a wide one.
If Marhaf takes 1,000 photos of yes. you will never get one.
Doc, you've got him sorted. I love it. Anybody else?
Yeah, everybody is with it, Murhaf. What is the situation with
it
you?
It is wonderful. It's great. Now, where is the boss? Because I think he's mixed some special cocktails for you outside. Then we're all going to go and have dinner. And don't forget, the doc is going to be watching at 6 o'clock in the morning. And if anybody's late, uh-oh. Thank you all very much indeed for coming. Let's relax and enjoy Abu Dhabi. Well done, top table.